everyone, and welcome. My name is Claudio. So glad you're here checking out this video. If you are visiting for the first time, thank you so much. If you are returning, thank you as well. Today, I'm going to walk you through how to create this really neat looking drop shadow effect using Adobe Express. So let's go ahead and check it out. Starting off at express.adobe.com, I'll click on the plus sign and I'll go ahead and go with the custom size graphic and just go with the default. You could always change this later on. Let's close that up. First thing I'll do is add a background color. This just makes it nicer, or I should say easier, to work with those drop shadows. Any color works. I'll go ahead and go with that one for now, and you can always change it up later. Your next step is to choose some text. I'll go ahead and add my own text, and I'll type in my name. A nice thick font works great. You can choose your favorite one. I'll go ahead and go with this one here, and I do want to choose white. I want to make sure, because that will just make it stand out much nicer and make this a little bit larger, center it up. Now my next step is to duplicate this text, and I'll go ahead and come up here to this option to duplicate. And what I'm going to do is actually move my main color to the top, just out of the way, and I'll move this one right behind it. I would say it's going to go just below slightly to create that drop shadow effect. And now my next step is to choose another color for the drop shadow. This one could be any color. You want something that pops. I'm gonna go with this really super bright red, and I want to have that at 100% opacity. So I want that to its full strength. And then what I'll do to this one is to duplicate that. And what happens is, as you begin to duplicate, it's going to add it to the layer above. So there's going to be some adjustment happening. Now for this one, since the color is already there, let me go ahead first off and zoom in just a little bit. So I'm using the command or alt plus sign just so we can see a little closer. It's a little tip there. And what I'm going to do here is adjust the opacity to go from 100 possibly to 80. And as you can see, there's already a big difference there. And of course, the one that I just changed to 80 is above, so I'm going to move it below, which really doesn't matter, but I think it will work much better that way. And I'll use my arrow keys to adjust. So you can see right there, we want that to have that drop shadow look. Now the next thing is to duplicate that layer. So you want to make sure you have that selected, and we'll go ahead and duplicate. And again, as I mentioned, it's going to jump up to the top. We're going to drag that below that last layer that I just created. And let's see here, let's make sure we got the right one. We got 80 80. Well, it didn't move below. Let's go ahead and make sure it is below. There it is, 80, and there's 180. We want to make sure I move the 100% to the top, and then you can see it's 100, and there is 80, and there's the next 80. Now we'll go to 60%, and we'll fine-tune that with the arrow keys. Slight difference, you can tell right there. Okay, now the next thing is we're going to duplicate that layer, and we'll go ahead and bring that one down. Just make sure it's there. Looks like I moved the 100. So there's 100, there's 80, there's 60, and there's the next 60. So we'll bring this one down to 40. You might have to play with the numbers a little bit. I'm going in increments of 20%, and it looks like we might have to make some adjustments to the numbers, but that's fine. So let's go ahead, and there's the 100%. There is, let's make sure that's in the right spot. And then let's go to the 60, there's the 40. So let's adjust the 60%. We're gonna move that one right below the 80, right about there. Good. And then we're gonna grab the 40% one and move that one right about there. So as you can see, getting closer to the effect we were looking for. There it is. Now let's just bring this one down, and we're going to move that one all the way to the top. So now we have my name there. Yeah, pretty cool. So you can continue, you can add another one, make it to 20%, but you get the idea, to create this really cool looking drop shadow effect. Now I'm going to do one thing here, is I'm going to group all these together. That way they move all together. And I'm going to go ahead and zoom out, control or command minus sign. I'm gonna move my name to the center. Let's move that out of the way, right about there. Let me zoom in so you can see much better. There we go. And we'll fine tune that. There we go. We have our drop shadow effect, and cool. There you go. You can add some really cool design assets behind here. Go to design assets and add a really cool looking background. Let's see if we can find one here. Let's see, effects. Let's see what one of these will look like. Maybe drop it to the back. Let's try that one there. That's cool. And what we'll do is we'll add that to the background. There we go. And possibly change that color out. Make it less opaque, I should say. Let's try that one. Very cool. I think what I'm going to do is remove it from the background. Make it larger. There we go. And now I can reduce that opacity. Let's take off the screen from there. There we go. Just barely there. There we go. Very cool. Got my drop shadow effect. Again, you can make adjustments to the percentages, but you get the idea, to make this really cool looking drop shadow effect. And that's how to create the drop shadow effect in Adobe Express. Now it's your turn to give it a try. If you have any comments or questions about this video, please do drop it in the comment section below. Don't forget, like, subscribe, click the bell to be notified for future videos, and don't forget to share this video with your friends. Thanks so much for stopping by, and as always, be good to one another. Peace.